Rabul Nagi Art Foundation is working to help slums fight COVID-19. Rabul Nagi's foundation is also providing place to uninfected kids of COVID-positive parents. Her foundation is providing essentials like ration kit, medical kit to slum areas. NewsX proudly recognizes second wave superhero Rabul Nagi and her foundation.
Hello and welcome. I'm Uday Pratap Singh. You're joining us on yet another interview as part of our second wave superheroes special series on NewsX. We are in conversation today with Rabul Nagi, founder of Rabul Nagi Art Foundation. Rabul, welcome to NewsX. Thank you so much for joining us.
Namaskar. Thank you so much. Very happy to be here.
Let me begin by just talking to you a bit about about the work that you've been doing in this very tough times. Tell us a bit about the relief work that you and your foundation have been carrying out.
So, you know, when the COVID lockdown last year happened in 2020, end March, a lot of people were finding it difficult because daily wages were not working anymore. Everyone was being quarantined and lockdown extended for more days than this time. So ration was the big issue, hygiene kits, because COVID was so new, everyone was not been able to understand that, you know, what exactly they are supposed to do, how to take the precautions. So we made over all the women in RNAF skill centers, made over 1 million masks. We distributed to different villages and to different slums across where we are working, and also many other areas there where we are not working. People approached us and we distributed, and we gave hygiene kits. We spoke about what are the basic things that you need to do, you know, wash your hands more regularly, try to stay at home. Even if, you know, in slums, you know, in one room, which is very small, you have 8-10 members. So it's very difficult when you say social distancing. So we explained to them that here you can't do social distancing, but what you can do is that all of you together stay at one place. So nobody from outside is coming and you're not going out. So first stage, first wave was when people were very scared. They didn't know what really happened. You know, what COVID-19 exactly was. Coronavirus kya hai, logon ko samajh mein nahi aa raha tha. Then slowly and gradually, you know, through different portals, through different people, they understood what it is and what is it that they should do. So we did initially start with distributing a lot of hygiene kits to people in slums and villages. And as lockdown was extended, people were finding it difficult for basic, the essentials of, you know, daily routine. So we distributed over 3 lakh families with ration kits across India. So this was first wave. Second wave was, I think, completely different from the need that we felt was during the first wave. You know, initially everyone was looking for hospital beds, oxygen, medicines, that. And then, you know, we started getting a lot of queries from parents, the family members in the slums, saying that, ma'am, our family members, both the parents have been tested COVID positive, and we have no place to leave our children. We don't have food to eat. We don't have any earning. We have nothing. So how do we sustain? So that is when we decided that RNAF's Balwadis, where we teach children, we converted it into daycare center where we can keep the children and look after them. And because my team has been working in the slums past over 10 years now, so it was very easy for people to trust and reach out to RNAF team members because they also live in those areas. So that is when we decided that, all right, we must take care of the kids, because, you know, when I heard a couple of cases which were very traumatic, I was like, you know what, I know it's a big responsibility, but we must do it. We cannot let children feel that they have no parents, because, you know, everyone was scaring everyone around, and kids were thinking the minute you get COVID, your parents are dead. You know, they're not going to come back home. So that was really affecting their mental health, and they were going through a lot of negative news, plus, you know, relatives and neighbors, everyone was not showing the kind of love and care, the hope that they needed when your parents are in the hospital or in isolation, that they were not getting. And that is when we decided that, all right, with few where we got maximum number of requests, we converted them into daycare centers and we started looking after the children. As the lockdown extended, again, we got a lot of requests for ration. Ma'am, now we thought the lockdown will be for a week or 10 days or 2 weeks. Now it's been close to a month, over a month. So now we've started an initiative called RNAF Food Initiative.
Okay.
First was COVID Childcare Center for Children, where we took care of the children. Yeah. And then the second initiative that we started during the second wave is food initiative of Ruben Nagyat Foundation. Okay. So we've just finished Jammu and Kashmir, and I came back to Delhi. We did many drives in Delhi, in Maharashtra. Tomorrow again, we are doing Sonipat, then a couple of areas in Bihar, Odisha. And now on Twitter and all through social media, we've got so many other areas where we can, we would want to send the ration and people really need it. So okay. I think now we are reaching out to people with the basics, the hygiene kits, along with the ration bags.
Great, great job, Rubal, that you've done, of course, through these two waves. And do you plan to continue this? Of course, your primary work is a art foundation, but do you plan when there is a need that you will continue this philanthropic work as well?
See, the main mission of Ruben Nagy Art Foundation is educating through art and employment through skilling. Mm-hmm. Our focus is education because we want every child in school and learning well. That is our motto, and our team is dedicated team. Mm-hmm. It was very unfortunate that COVID-19 had to be a part of all of us, like our lives. But this is something we've been doing over 10 years now.
Yeah.
So of course work continues, but we would, as a human being, as a woman, I would hope that, we continue the good work, but we don't have to see people in so much trouble, going through so much with a pandemic like COVID.
Yeah.
But of course the work will continue.
Okay.
I mean, we are kind of, you can say we are in control of second wave right now, but COVID is still very much a part of our life.
True.
So we are now actually, we've, along with our ration drives, everywhere that I go, I take the mic and I say that how important it is for everyone to get vaccinated.
Absolutely.
Vaccine lena bahut zaruri hai, tika lagwaye jaldi se jaldi, hum sabko yehi bolte hain. Kashmir mein, in fact, I was very happy to see, because 40 villages that my team reached out to, in that you can say 75% people have taken their vaccination.
Fantastic.
So I think this is something need of PR right now, and everybody must get. Yes, yes. And people have a lot of negativity about vaccination.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I'm not feeling well. Maybe I'll die after the vaccination. So all these myths also need to be, cleared out of their brain.
Busted.
The only way forward is vaccination. So we are also, kind of educating people and requesting them to take their elders, take their family members for vaccination. And of course, work will continue. The only thing I hope right now is that situation comes in control and our balwaris and skill centers, we can reopen and have children and youngsters and women start working and learning with us again.
Okay, well, we certainly wish for that to happen very soon. Thank you so much, Ruben Nagy, for joining us.
Thank you.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.